this is Robert Hanson, 2018 gardening. Okay, we would like that you see the equipment, tools, and the materials that we will be using. Okay, this is from leaving it set out for a while. that's okay. And you always want to make sure when you get totes, they're food preparation ones, not chemicals. Okay, people. Totes, barrels, plastic barrels. Okay. And you see the lines and all that. Where we're going to cut. We're going to separate in the center. You see where that plant pan is, okay? Now, all the way around is how we're going to cut. Okay? We're going to make a PVC top for them, okay? For the sole purpose of keeping warmth, heat, some moisture and all in, insects, rodents, birds and all out, plus in fertilizer, certain fertilizers you have to watch out for, I guess. But weed killer, any kind of stuff that farmers sprays that can harm plants, we don't want in our garden. So that's the reason why we're building a greenhouse top for them. We're going to try, okay? Now, what you see here, if you tried, or if you see what we have done wrong, okay, with the size of materials, and you see the soil, okay, and why we doing, and the soil shrinks after the new year, okay, you see how far down to the first bar. Well, by the 2019, it went farther down, it did. What my brother did is he put dirt, paper, and that mixed in with it, then planted some seed plants in it to germinate to get going, to get the process of the soil working right. Okay. If you want to clean up your soil and create a good, luscious yard, okay, depends on your soil, what brand of soil you got, zone, and if your yard is like a slope, like you're living on a small hill, okay, you have to take that in consideration, because the house my parents, where this is, it's got like a little slope, so when you put them down, you gotta make sure you correct all that in to where same wind or anything else won't come able to, okay. There's a greenhouse there, and one that my brothers built as well too, with the plants in it, okay. He stuck worms in it as well, alright. You need worm castings and into it. see how all what he has done. Alright. This is 2018 video. Construction of the greenhouse. He using iron. Will it work or won't it work? Okay. Have anyone used totes as well? And another reason why my brother decided to use totes is that, okay, it was brought up. Okay, when your soil is somewhat moist, okay, but the water falls right through regular grown beds, okay, open ground under it. Nothing there to hold in the water. Plus, your pH, the food that you put for your pH washes out down the bottom. So there's no way for your pH balance to stay a little longer than necessary, but it washes out farther down, okay? It goes farther down into the ground where you plants can't get to it. Okay. And as well too, insects or something about it. Have it happen to you? Have insects or rodents or animals dug up through under it? Nobody knows. Have they? Would like to know. For when we can create our own, we know what to do or what not to do. Okay. Home farming. Okay. Our ideals might help, or we would like to see what other ideals that are out there. You see how we're doing? We're trying something different. Again. Okay. You know how thick it's not too thick, but okay. And the plants that's growing, okay, is putting it. Okay. And there's two of them, greenhouse and a wow. Okay. And what it does, it protects the plants and protects the people. Okay. Because when you have, okay, you see these plants, you see the soil. Okay. The green around it, pebbles as well. Do you know what kind of plants they are by looking at them? Okay. I would like for people that does know what kind of plants by looking and seeing. I would like them to tell us what they are. Okay. Our neighbors are doing lawnmower one, and if that's the reason why you're hearing it for, that's what it is. Part is, alright, why I say zones, each zone's a different type of temperature, states, and all that, okay, like, you would, Okay, because where I'm, where the zone is, zone 6, and sometimes ours reaches up to 120 temperature at summertime. July and August, okay. And that's the reason why I say that. It's because you want something that can help keep moisture in the soil for a while, okay. And if you water on real hot, they would say wait until dark or somewhat dark, but let the temperature of the soil gradually cool down before you add any water. Drastic temperature change could hurt your plants, okay? So what do you think? This is Robert Hansen, share of you, and like, be more information and all on more about other wonderful and ideals we would like to find out, okay? Newer ideals, insects, what I say about keeping contact about with insects and all, cause everyone, it affects your home farming, okay, for people that don't have the large amount of money. We got to do what we can to do it. Thank you. Okay. And, one other thing, when you do, always check your soil to make sure there's no foreign objects that can stop your roots from growing, okay? And understand, and to always find out what plants will grow with close to one another and what won't grow, and what plants will grow in certain things, like peat moss or pineapple hair, coconut hair, okay. Some do and some don't. You always need to find out about it, okay. Because it creates a lot. It might not let the plant grow to the full extent. And, apples and all that, find out what next thing is close to your zone that you can grow, if it's possible, okay? Let us know your ideals, okay? If you take, gumballs, throw them into the soil, do they add more nourishment for your plants? Because you still have to think about what it does it take a gumball, how much energy does it take to create gumballs? pH level, all the materials that it takes to create whatever a gumball, nuts, berries, and all that.
Okay.
Stuff that. Alright. Thank you. This is Robert Hansen, 2018. Share, like, and respond. Alright.